Welcome to Metal Injection Spotlight. Over the next few weeks, I'll be on a headbanger's journey to explore where metal culture lives and breathes around the globe. Join me as we visit all the best metal hangouts and shine a spotlight on those who keep the culture alive. Hey guys, what's up? Today I'm in Copenhagen, Denmark, a city where history and fresh new perspective clearly coexist. But when you hear the word Copenhagen, the band that often stands out the most is, of course, Mercyful Fate. So today I'm meeting up with Michael Denner, the band's lead guitar player turned record shop owner, right here in his hometown. What's up, guys? I'm here in Copenhagen at Beat Bop Records with Michael Denner. Michael, this is a shop that you've had for a while. What was the backstory to this? Were you doing this while you were with Mercyful Fate, or
my childhood dream was, of course, to be a famous electric lead guitarist, you know, in some band, you know. So, but this dream number two was to have my own record shop. So when I fulfilled the first dream with Mercyful Fate and later on King Diamond, I had some time off in Copenhagen to think things over, I decided to open my first shop, and that was around 1988.
I heard that working in a record shop could be a dream come true to some people. What's your favorite part about owning your own record shop?
My favorite part about it is when people come in with boxes, their collections and so on, the magic moment to go through the box and maybe find something very interesting, you know. And also records that people have been asking me about for years, and I finally find it in the box, you know. So, wow, they can call somebody who will be very happy, you know.
What kind of customers do you usually get, like old fans of yours, or just like locals, or?
Yeah, it's a mix. Of course, there's a lot of people who want to come in here and buy a Mercyful Fate album and get it signed, you know, handshakes, photos, and so on. And I'm very happy that people still do this, because without them, I will be nothing, you know. And also because I, on off these years, you know, been playing with different bands and doing albums and so on. So this is very important for me to let people know that I'm still here as a guitarist, very much. I counted the albums I played on a few weeks ago, and it was up to 35 different albums, you know. There's a lot of people who think I quit the business after I left Mercyful Fate the last time, 17 years ago. Right. But I've been very active since.
And I have Force of Evil.
Oh, yeah, of course. And my new band, Trickback. And we have a new album out in September, you know, and I mean, I play more guitars now than ever, you know. So it's been a fantastic life for me, you know, to run my shop. My dream came true there, and also still the guitar.
And you know, I've actually read a couple of reviews from your patrons that said that you have a real knack for finding them great music, and I was just wondering, do you think that has anything to do with, you know, you working as a professional musician?
Like I told a lot of people, I have many uniforms, you know. I'm a record store owner, I'm a guitarist, I run the biggest music trivia in Denmark, you know, and I work as a journalist for Metalized. That opens some doors for me, you know, and broaden my world.
And you know, talking about this whole trivia thing, from what I understand, you entered it. You started as a contestant on it, right?
Yes,
and I did. You're not allowed to be a contestant anymore.
I won the two first competitions. When I tried to return to the next regular, the Copenhagen trivia, there I say no way. You're not going to. So I decided to be part of the team of judges, you know, and be behind the desk, you know, and do the questions. Because like my big passion for music and trivia, you know, sit for hours and read books about records, B-sides of singles, and so on and so on. Why not use that as something for everybody to enjoy? You know?
You have a great metal collection, as I've seen here.
I mean, this could be better, because every time I get a good collection of metal records, there's a lot of people come here and they just buy them. So
such a problem for a
record. I have a small collection. I wish I had a very big metal collection. I wish I had a big Mercyful Fate pile of records, and Diamond and so on. Because people come and ask me.
I mean, you've been in Mercyful Fate through what I call like the golden years, like all the best records.
Oh yeah, yeah. I'm a big fan.
What I know, you probably have a lot of fond memories. What would you say is your favorite memories?
One of my favorite, it must be recording Melissa, that album. You know, the atmosphere in the band was so good. It was a bit more tense when we did Don't Break the Oath, because King and Hank were starting to go in different directions. But at the point where we made Melissa, the band was so strong, the friendship was strong. You know, we're just about right before the big breakthrough. You know, that was when we did Melissa. So that's one of the best memories I have, and also the close friendship we had at the band at that point.
You know? If you ever find yourself in Copenhagen, check out Michael Denner, meet him, great guy at Beat Bop Records.